Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. In this video, I want to talk to you a little bit about one of my clients that had an extraordinary testimony that I want to share with you. She not only reversed endometriosis pain, she started ovulating. She hadn't ovulated since she was 15 years old, and she is now in her 30s. She was told by her doctors that she was barren, that she would never have children. When she was 17 years old, they wanted to give her a hysterectomy because her reproductive system was so riddled with reproductive issues that they didn't know what to do with her. Before she began my program, she was anemic, and she was checked and verified by the doctor that she was no longer anemic. The doctor said, keep doing what you're doing because it's working. And the reason I want to highlight this particular testimony is because endometriosis is not really talked about very much, but there are so many women who not only have fibroids, but they also have endometriosis. And this particular client had both. One of the things I can say about endometriosis is, one, I have not been riddled with endometriosis over my complete abdomen like some women have, but I had a little spot of it. And when it would flare up, the pain was so excruciating that I can't even comprehend or understand how someone with a full belly of endometriosis can actually survive, because the pain is that great. With the little piece that I had, it was probably about this big. It was like unbelievably, horribly bad. So I can't even imagine, but I'm sharing this testimony with you because if you have endometriosis pain, you can reverse it by doing what I teach in my 90-day Walk to Freedom from Fibroids group coaching program and everything that I teach here on this channel. So just follow. If you are struggling with endometriosis pain, if you're not ovulating, if you're anemic, follow my advice. It will help you. So I'm going to cut to the audio where you hear my client talking about how she's getting well, and then I will come and wrap up.
What went well for me was the fact that I got my cycle and I was not hospitalized. That's what went well for me. Like, it's almost about to make me cry because it's been a rough road, and I've been dealing with that since I was about 15. I'm in my 30s. So it's to the point where, like, the local hospital knows me on a first name basis. Like, when I come through the door, they already know, like, what I'm there for. And they just hook me up to, you know, yes, B. Wendy, praise the Lord, hallelujah, because I'm telling you, like, this is something that I have dealt with for such a long time. And, you know, just, and I even think that I was having like ovulation pains. I couldn't figure out what was happening because I haven't ovulated since I was 16. So I was just like, is this my body, like, you know, this might be TMI, but is this my body like releasing the mucus, or is this actually what ovulation looks like? And I mean, I've been doing what you have been talking about, just being really positive. And I mean, the fact that I'm sitting here in my house talking to you today is nothing short of a miracle. And I thank God so much for this, you know, for him even leading me to do something like this. I mean, it's just amazing when you actually like dedicate yourself and you keep trying. You know, like, every day is not perfect. You know, when I did fall I think someone in the chat posted about funnel cakes, and I went to the beach like 2 weeks ago and I ate like a little bit of a funnel cake, but it actually made my stomach kind of hurt, kind of. So I just kind of like left it alone. But I mean, it's, I just, may God bless you, Chelsea. I mean, for what you are doing, what you're pouring out. I mean, may he truly bless you and your family, because this is just, it's just amazing when you actually think about what your body was created to do. And when you give it that chance to do it, like, these doctors are going to scratch their heads. Like, and to the lady who was talking about anemia, I know that that can be really scary, but I had blood work done about a couple weeks ago, and the doctor literally said to me, I don't know what you're doing, but keep doing it because you're no longer anemic. So it is possible. For those that, you know, I'm a believer in Christ, and I will go in 2 seconds. So I'm trying real hard to speak in English. So, but I'm just here to let, I think her name, thank you, Holy Spirit. Her name is Patricia. Patricia, I want you to be encouraged, because it can happen where you will not be anemic. And I'm going to be in prayer that the Lord gives you that testimony, because, again, I just can't thank God enough for each and every one of you ladies, and especially you, Chelsea. May God continue to make your ministry flourish, because this is, my body is doing stuff that I didn't even know I was capable of doing, because from such a young age, and I mean like 18, I was told, you know, you're barren, you'll never be able to bear children. They wanted to give me a hysterectomy then. And my parents were like, absolutely not. And, you know, I can talk for hours, but I mean, just, I am so excited. And I, you know, went for a walk yesterday. And even while on my period, I only had to take my ibuprofen like maybe 3 times. And that is unheard of. Usually when I get my cycle, I'm on hardcore, like Percocet, Vicodin, hardcore pain medicine, even to survive throughout the day. It's just amazing.
Wasn't that an amazing testimony? I mean, at that point, we had only been working together maybe 6 weeks. And she had gotten those results that quickly. Let me just tell you, when you set in your mind that you want to change and you actually really change, you actually do the work behind it, and then you put some prayers behind that work, let me just tell you, miracles can happen. And God is not a respecter of persons. If he could do what my client got for her, he could do it for you. If he'll do something for me, he'll do it for you. Like, he will do it all for us. But we've got to put some skin in the game sometimes. Sometimes we can't just sit there and pray and say, please, God, heal me, and expect him to just zap us, and then we'd be healed. Sometimes that happens, but sometimes there's some things he wants us to walk through. There's some things that he wants us to stop doing so that we can stop being in the situation that we're in. I don't know about you, but I can tell you that my reproductive issues were wrapped all around emotional issues, emotional stuff, things that happened to me in my past, things that I, you know, made choices to do that affected how my body was responding. And, you know, until, you know, I got with God and asked him to come in and heal some of that emotional stuff, was I I wasn't able to really heal physically until I started going after some of that stuff. So sometimes that's the case for some of you as well. I see you every time I come on live. Some of you are here every week. I'm sorry, not every week, but every time I come on live, and like some of you will have the same questions, the same problems, the same issues. And what I'm seeing is that God wants to get at your heart. It's not always about the actual fibroid or the endometriosis or the ovarian cyst. Because when we get healed emotionally, we have the ability to do the thing that we've been trying so hard to do. And I know some of you are hearing me talk and you're like, what in the world are you talking about, Chelsea? I can't tell you how many of my clients say to me, you know, Chelsea, I joined your program because, you know, I wanted to learn what it is I needed to do so that I could heal my body, like what foods to eat, how to detox, what herbs to take, all that stuff. I joined the program because of that. But what I recognized is that I actually needed my soul healed. I needed the emotional healing piece of this puzzle. And then they start to dig deeper, and then other areas of their lives start to heal and get opened up, and they're doing things that they didn't think that they could do, you know, even just a year ago or 6 months ago, because they were all balled up emotionally. I don't know that I even wanted to talk about this in this video, but it sort of kind of flowed out. So I guess I'm just going to go ahead and share it with you. A lot of the physical pain that we experience in our lives is a direct correlation of what's going on in our hearts. And one of those things for endometriosis specifically is usually self-inflicted emotions, like you're mad at yourself because, you know, you didn't do what you wanted to do, or you regret decisions that you made, so you hate yourself, or you got an abortion, so now you can't have children and you're mad at yourself, or you're mad at your mother, or you're mad at your aunt, you're mad at your grandmother. Like, there's all these things that can be connected to what is keeping you not well. And you keep on spinning your wheels trying to do something to feel better, and it's not working. So if this has touched your heart, if this video has touched your heart in any way and you feel like you need help, just click the link down in the description box. And hit apply to work with me. We could just talk to see if you're a fit for me and if I'm a fit for you, because it's got to go both ways. It's not just about me. And if you have questions, type them in the comment sections, or if you have video ideas, put that in the comment section, and I'll be glad to try and make a video to answer your questions. But if you want to get well, you can. It's possible. It's not always easy walking through this journey, but it is doable. It's definitely doable. And you are worth it. So I just want to share that with you, and I will talk to you all soon. Take care.